is the background check. My college roommate was supposed to be here, but he had a family emergency. His name is Sheldon Sanders. I met him my freshman year when I was 17 years old at Central Michigan University. We go back like fourth lesson in Cadillac. My man hunted Brandon 25 years, a good friend of mine. He made sure that I didn't get in any trouble with Central Michigan because he knew I wanted to be a police officer like my father. So he got in all the trouble. No trouble left for me to get in. I just want to say thank you, Shannon, wherever you are right now. To my mother, Joanne Young. When I began my career, my father had 25 years of law enforcement in with the Detroit Police Department. She endured 25 years of being a spouse to a police officer and was about to begin another career as a mother to another law enforcement officer. I'm pretty sure she wasn't too erratic about me becoming a police officer. Matter of fact, I know she wasn't, as I overheard a conversation that she had the day after I graduated from the police academy. It went something like this. Girl, when we graduated from the police academy yesterday, I knew I should have taken him to the doctor after I dropped him on his head. Oh well, too late now. I give my dad all the credit for getting me into law enforcement, but my mom gets all the credit for keeping me here. My dad always heard all the fun stories about me getting in pursuits, about me catching a bad guy. My mom heard all the complaints, all my fears, all my frustrations. My mom heard every single one of them. My dad never heard them. Bad days, terrible days, horrible days. My mom got those phone calls or those visits. There's something about a mom that just makes everything better, especially mine. Yeah, I'm a mom's boy, it's okay. I would not be here accepting this award without you, Mom. I love you, Mom. You did a good job in passing that torch to my beautiful wife, Shannon. The chief said he has never seen me lose my cool. He's never seen me angry. And that is absolutely the truth. I resorted to that for when I'm off duty and when I get home from my family. You can thank the later chief. The saying that you take things out on the people that are closest to you is very true. I know my wife right now was thinking, well, we must be closer than peanut butter and jelly. Remember when I told you that being married to me would not be easy, and it may be one of the toughest feats of your life, but I'm here to tell you, I kept my word. You also kept your word. You said, no matter what, you will love me unconditionally, you will be here for me for better or worse. Then you said, come over here with your big ears and give me smooches. To my sons, thank you for giving me another reason to make it home at the end of the day. You are all the bright spots in my life. You two, Darian and Addison, even though y'all know it's like Cameron can be, you are the bright spots. As Cameron would say, I love you all higher than the moon. To my Battle Creek Police Department family, thanks to retired Chief Jackie Hampton, retired Lieutenant Ray Felix, current Commander Austin Simons, and current Lieutenant John Crianco. From day one as a Battle Creek police officer, they have assisted me in growing as an officer and personally as a man. How they have assisted me goes beyond the realm of work, and I am truly blessed to be able to say that these individuals are my friends. The reason I'm thanking this next person has already been expressed. I didn't know if this was happening. The best way that I can express why I'm thanking her is to give an example of a phone call between myself and Sharon Williams. Hello? Sharon, what day? I need a huge favor. What day? I need a whole favor, I'm in a jam. What day, man? I need a picture of Snoopy, red shoestring, 12 inches long, and boil egg, and I need it by noon. Please help me get this done. Bye! 11:55, I get the phone call. Are you coming to pick this up or what? As it was mentioned earlier, Sharon is the go-to person in our police department. And since 1996, I've been going to Sharon, and I want to say thank you tremendously. Set my cards down because I'm wrapping it up, but someone always told me the best thing, the best way to start is from the heart. Last but not least, I have to thank my father. The day I graduated, from the police academy, my dad sat me down. I was in Battle Creek uniform, but I was already hired by the city of Battle Creek. He told me, when he asked me, he said, "What's your number one weapon, son?" Being fresh out of the police academy, I said, "My gun." He said, "No, it's God." "God is your number one weapon in life. Always remember that." He said, "If you stay in this occupation long enough, you're going to have to believe in something more than us." He was 100% correct in that. He went on to tell me that to do your job effectively, you never have to demean anybody. In the course of me telling this story, many of you maybe have heard this before because I reiterated to officers as they come into the department because it was very valuable to me. He said, to do your job effectively, you never have to demean anyone. And at the time I was looking down at the ground, he said, "Dang it, look at me." I raised my eyes and I looked out in his eyes. He reiterated, "To do your job effectively, you never have to demean anyone. Do you understand that?" I said, "Yes." He said, "Treat people the way that you would like to be treated." He said, "Furthermore, treat someone how you want your mother to be treated if she had to deal with the police." He knew that would get me because, once again, I'm a mom. He went on to tell me that when the police are called, they're usually dealing with citizens. It possibly can be just a routine call for us. But for that citizen, it could be one of the worst days, if not the worst day of their life. He said our interaction with the citizens may help shape and form the way citizens look at police for the rest of their lives. He went on to tell me, treat people the way you want to be treated. If they act like a gentleman, treat them like a gentleman. If they act like a lady, treat them like a lady. If they act like a donkey, it's time to ride. He said, but you let them dictate that. You never go into that with your saddle ready to ride. I took that to heart and I really began my police career with that in my heart. And to this day, I continue to patrol and police like that. It's difficult times now for us as law enforcement officers over the last few years. It's difficult time for the community as well. We have to dig deep within ourselves and honestly find the reason why we wanted to be police in the beginning. And I'm pretty sure when we look back at why we signed up for this, it comes to be said we wanted to make a difference for people. It's difficult sometimes to find those reasons why we did this job, but I will tell you, I received confirmation this past Saturday of a great magnitude that we are making a difference. The article of me being placed, being named Officer of the Year was ran in the newspaper on Saturday morning. Battle Creek Central's prom was Saturday evening. I had to work at being a school liaison officer. When I arrived at the prom, many of the staff thanked me for being at the school and congratulated me for being Officer of the Year. The students bombarded me with hugs, handshakes, pictures, stating that I was their Officer of the Year. In saying that, it may not seem like much to people who just hear it, but I'm here to tell you, those same students 4 or 3 years ago when they entered Battle Creek Central High School wouldn't even speak to me. They didn't mess with the police. They didn't like the police. They didn't talk to 12, that's our nickname on the streets. For those students to come, take photos with me, congratulate me, and hug me. And not only do that, but they put it on Snapchat and on Instagram and on Facebook as the millennials do. It meant a great deal that we're doing something right as a police department. A big deal. But it's not just me. It's every officer in this room. It's Officer Francisco, who works at the park every summer at the basketball games. It's Officer Bohannon, Corporal Bohannon, who participates in the kickball tournament. And it's all other officers who participated in the basketball game that was set up with the Boys and Girls Club. I greatly appreciate you all's efforts, especially the ones who play basketball, knowing you couldn't throw the ball in the ocean, let alone a basketball game. I still get talked about that to this day. But with that, I'd like to say I appreciate the award, and this is all of our awards. Thank you.